Many times twin-twin transfusion is first suspected when you have a twin pregnancy that appears to be monochorionic or shares a placenta, and there's a size difference between the baby and an amniotic fluid volume difference.
The information that we receive from our referring physicians allows us to be able to ascertain how urgent we would need to evaluate our patients.
So we make arrangements very shortly, usually within 1 to 2 days, for them to visit the center.
If we feel that based on the information that we receive that the clinical situation is critical, then we will make certain to see our patients within 24 hours.
When I initially talk to families, I get a sense of what they understand of the pregnancy. I also try to allay a little bit of their fear by telling them that we're not certain what the diagnosis is, and it's important for them to come in for an evaluation so that we can confirm the diagnosis.
There are other conditions that can mimic the findings. As a matter of fact, for every 10 referrals that we get, about 2 out of the 10 prove to be something else.
There's typically 5 areas we look at. Is there one placenta? Are they the same sex? Is there the same amount of fluid in one sac versus the other sac? How are the cords inserted? And then importantly, what are the cardiac echo findings?
When patients arrive to our center for evaluation, part of their evaluation consists of a very detail-oriented ultrasound examination, as well as a detail-oriented fetal echocardiogram.
Because we believe the origins of the disease of twin-twin transfusion syndrome are cardiovascular, it is essentially important to begin the evaluation process implementing fetal echocardiography.
Utilizing the results from the examinations, including the ultrasound examination as well as the fetal echocardiogram, we can then create a composite which allows us to stage the twin-twin transfusion syndrome.
Once that evaluation is complete that same day, we sit down with the family and go over the results of those tests and explain what their options are for the pregnancy and what would most likely be the scenarios that would happen depending upon which option they chose.
We try to be non-directive. We try to, first of all, present what the problem is, what we believe the pathologic process is, why it's progressive. We then present all the forms of therapy.
The consultation period is a time for families to ask as many questions as they have.
We really put it out on the table. We educate them about the risks, the potential benefits, what's reported in the literature as to survivals, complications, outcomes, and then we really work in concert with the family to decide what's the best thing for them.